people moving in shared vehicles. People who don't know one another, they just meet in a minibus or a taxi or a bus. Even border borders, although they carry less people, but those two people are close to one another. Well, therefore, and this enables people to move from one end of the country to the other end. The person who went to Kisumu and back to Jinja did not walk to Kisumu. He traveled by fast means. That's why, therefore, the government has decided to suspend for 14 days now all public transport. And this means all taxis, all coasters, minibuses, all buses, all passenger trains, all tuk-tuks, the tricycles, and all the border borders. These all are suspended. Why? Because we don't want to minimize movement. Therefore, the only vehicle that will be moving will be private vehicles, but they should not carry more than three people, including the driver. Therefore, even a private vehicle parked with family members is not allowed. That's why all those functions should be postponed. Family, people going home for Easter, all that. Wait. Let's first get out of this danger. Now, the other vehicles that will continue moving will be the trucks, the lorries, delivering cargo. Don't use the lorries to transport people. What we are struggling with here is passengers, abasabaze. So the trucks will be carrying cargo, bananas, whatever, delivery vans, pickups, all strictly for food and other essential commodities. Even the border borders, if they want to carry food, we have no problem. Border borders can carry bunches of bananas. They can carry, the tuk-tuks can carry cargo. Because bananas don't breathe. Because remember, this sickness goes through breathing. through breathing, through the nose and the mouth. So that's why we are targeting the human beings. So the trucks, the lorries should use our language, which we know well. The lorries, the minibuses, the pickups, even the border borders and the tuk-tukus carrying goods are not a problem. They can continue, but not carry people, not carry passengers. Passengers would only move in private cars. And those should be not more than three. The other vehicles that will continue moving will be the ambulances. The ambulances of the Ministry of Health, then the vehicles of the security forces, the army, the police. Some of the institutional houses, of the institutional vehicles, some of the institutional vehicles, institutional meaning government vehicles, doing essential work. Vehicles for sanitary services, like the ones of the city council taking away the garbage, taking away Kasasiro, those will be allowed to move. So this is the additional measure we have said to take to discourage, to postpone, to cause people to postpone their unsafe journeys from one point to another point. The only people who can move safely, as I said, are those using private cars. But even those should not be more than three, including the driver. So that is additional measure number one. You remember the measures we started with were 13. Then we added another, I think, two or three. So we are now adding more. So you should total up these measures. Once we deal with public transport, then the other remaining big problem are the markets. The markets should only be now for selling foodstuffs. Only food. And what do we mean by food? Matoke, sweet potatoes, cassava, rice, beans, cowpeas, groundnuts, beef, chicken, fruits, vegetables, etc. Food, emere, charm. Therefore, trading in the markets other non-food items is from now onward suspended. The selling of clothes, the selling of necklaces, the selling of mobile phones, the selling of all those sandals, shoes, all those non-food items. Hold on. Hold on, you'll come back, but let's just to create space, stay at home, let only the food people stay in the market. We think this will reduce numbers, and then they can be able to maintain what they call the social distance. I don't know why they call it social distance, because actually it is unsocial. Because you say tonsembera. So how can you call tonsembera social distance? They should call it either medical distance or whatever. So we think that by removing the non-food items and sellers from the market, it will reduce the numbers. Now, once we deal with the public transport, and we deal with the market to some extent, the other area of human concentration are the offices, government offices. That's why each ministry should work out a plan of the essential staff that need to remain on duty. Take, for example, the revenue authority must remain on duty, because our goods are still coming from outside Uganda and coming into Uganda. Somebody needs to clear those goods, needs to collect the taxes. So they would have to sit down in the URA and see how many people are needed, maybe in a rotation. Some can work for some time and then go home, and others come and work. So you cannot say everybody go home with the government departments, because then the economy will shut down. So therefore, each department should work out the essential staff that are needed to remain on duty. Even in the districts, the district officials can identify borders who can deliver food and other cargo to wherever it is needed. This crisis will teach us other methods of doing business. Because really here we are not saying that don't do business. No, but do business without too much human movement. And especially using shared means of transport. This is what we are saying. However, even when you have your shared means of transport, like for instance, going to the supermarket, even if you have got your own vehicle, how many people should be allowed in the supermarket at the same time? This is not the other market. This is a supermarket which is a high class type. If there's too much overcrowding there, people entering, leaving, it may become a problem. So that's why, even for all these groups, it is better to use deliveries by a few people. The borders here can don't have to say, oh, we have nothing to do. No, they can change. Instead of carrying people, which causes risk, they can start carrying things from the supermarket to address number this, from the market to address number this, so that we have both. We have both business, but also safety. So just really reorienting the way of doing business without exposure. In Kampala, companies will be identified and licensed to start doing this delivery business of borders. But I hope there will be no corruption here and bribery. I want to know why there would be any limit. Because really that's not the main point. The main point is that if you move around, but move around goods, not people. So be careful about that point of so it doesn't cause quarrels. They have refused me, they have allowed the other one. So you study that carefully. As long as they are not carrying people, they are carrying goods, be careful. You don't have to be involved in the blocking this one and allowing the other one.